We are here in the Faculty of Bioscience Engineering of the Katholieke Universiteit Leuven. And in the research team, we started from climate control in the past. That is what we do. So the whole group was doing research on controlling what we call environment around animals and plants. We moved to bioresponses. That is whatever variable that you can measure on animals, how an animal is responding to that environment. And when we started the research in like 75 in the research team, then already we were wondering, why are we measuring like variables like temperature and not directly on the animal? So the research team has moved to what we call measuring bioresponses for monitoring and control purposes. So we do monitoring. We do a modeling, because that's a key technical in the solution, and management. So what we call precision livestock farming means that we try to measure automatically, continuously, those biological responses on animals, on livestock. It's very important that we do it continuously. That's related to living organisms. Living organisms are very complex. They are individually different. They are time varying. That means the way they respond to something is every time different. For example, a farmer walks into his pigsty with a red cap on his head. They will look to him different the first time than the second time. So time variant in the responses, and then dynamic. So complex, individually different, time varying, dynamic. Precision livestock farming means, we call it PLF shortly. That means that we use technology to measure those responses continuously, automatically, because the farmer cannot be there the whole day. Today it's impossible, because he's forced to have too many animals to make his living out of it. Really, the society is forcing him. And if we look to the challenges coming to us, precision livestock farming, PLF, allows this fully automatically, continuously, and that is what we need to help these animals being healthy with high welfare and high productivity, because that's the key of the whole process, is the animal. And it's the farmer who has to take care of that. PLF gives him a tool. So he will still take decisions, but now he gets a tool to be helped. Now we have reached a point in time that a few problems are coming together in the next 5 to 10 years. The first one is that the worldwide demand for meat will increase dramatically. So the expectations is that in the next 15 years, the demand for meat will increase with over 40%. So we need more meat production. But at the same time, the number of farmers is reducing. So that means there will be less farms and we need more livestock. So farms will become bigger. That means that the time that the farmer has to spend time with his animals to monitor is even reducing. PLF can help him, to give him time to do all that monitoring continuously, automatically, that he gets the data. Because an animal in that status will guarantee a higher production. That is the goal, the final goal. If we want PLF to monitor animals continuously, that is like every second or every minute in an automatic way, indeed the question is all that technology affordable for a farmer? But the basic thing with technology is that the cost of it is only related to one main thing, that is the numbers, how many numbers are produced. We can see that with like a mobile phone. Who could imagine like 10 years ago that today eight years old children, they get a mobile phone for 50 euro. So it's the same thing. It's the numbers that decide on the price. Whether the farmer can make money with it, that's a totally different thing. You have the cost, but the question is, where is the added value? How do we create added value for him? There is so many examples that show us that if we have few variables that we can catch continuously, where the information is, that would help him. So what we need to do is to show the relationship between monitoring those variables and the money he makes at the end of that fattening period, for instance. And farmers who are using the technology today, they can experience that. Another misunderstanding is that it is a so complex system. I mean the technology as such. I don't think it's true, and let me give one example. If everybody of us is watching his partner, then you can use facial expression to understand about the mental status. Like, I know whether my wife is angry or happy by looking to facial expression. So I see a few variables and I can get conclusions from there. That is what we do with the animals. We see how they move, what is the posture, what is the sound they make, and from there we make conclusions. Now, is a farmer is relating that to his income and he is projecting those two lines, he will see that there is a very high coherence between those lines. So that is the challenge for us, to make PLF to a tool that will give him more income. Because at the end of the day, if the farmer who has to do the investment is not having that benefit, it will not happen. And their industry comes in the picture to get the numbers, to get the product at that cost that the farmer can afford it, to bring it to him in the market. That is where industry is important, and where in this case Fancom is important as a world leading company in PLF, because they have to make the product and they have to go the long trajectory from the idea in science and the lab to bring it to the market to an affordable product. If we listen in that way to PLF, it sounds very technical, but in reality the core business of it is not technical at all. A farmer, he knows what an animal is. The technique, the technology is just a tool. Now, what we did in a European project, it's called BioBusiness, because we are aware that it's the animal people, like the farmer or the veterinarian or the ethologist or the animal scientist. These biologically educated people will develop new PLF projects in strong collaboration with those companies. If we now look to the future, the near future, because the call for a new project in Europe will come, it's a 6 million euro call, that is a huge investment for PLF in Europe. What is important there is that we see what are the variables we try to measure. There used to be a big project in Europe, which was the welfare quality project. In that project has been defined variables that are a measure for animal welfare. So with the new project, what we will try to do is measure those variables that have been defined for cows, for pigs and for poultry in a fully automatic way. So it shows that continuous monitoring is a key. That is what industry has to bring. In the case of Fancom with Leuven, we are next year working together for 20 years. That is quite unique, because I'm really convinced that a long-term exclusive agreement in research is the key for success. The reason why you test out many innovative ideas is because you are so open with each other in good and bad times. And you are so honest that every idea can be tested out. And so next year we have to celebrate that, because Fancom went from a climate control company into the core business now, which is the animal. It's all around the animal. And that's a huge step to turn over a company from being in climate control hardware to being more software animal-oriented company. That's a huge challenge, because what we've learned also in innovation is in the last 30 years, we have developed about 13 products that went in collaboration with industry, that went from the lab to a product in the world market. But that is only one out of 10 prototypes that is really tested out. And at the end, for some reason, it doesn't go to the market. So it's very important that we have a very intensive collaboration there. And Fancom is special for us because I've learned them when there was only 3 people in the company starting up so long ago. And now I'm really curious where we will bring it together as pioneers in PLF and see whether we can bring that to the community, which is just a big challenge. So I'm very curious together with Fancom.